Listen, anybody on any day could get put to sleep. You know, my man the other day, I was talking on the phone, he said it best. Everybody got a shelf life, baby, when it comes to that boxing.
He's 46-0 right now.
I know, but I just think Money May gonna do his thing. Like, okay. I'm just rooting for him, and I want to see him get out of there perfect. But I know he flashed the money, and I know how people
like
out
that.
There feeling.
I like that.
He can be a little aggravated.
I'm
you know
not
that,
mad.
But I love him.
I'm not mad.
I just love him. Yeah, I love him anyway. And
I just wish you'd go ahead and take that 50 challenge and go ahead and read something, though.
Oh, no. No. No.
Just
no.
Pick something up and read. Just no. To show the folks no. That I can read. Man, just do it. Just
man,
do it, man.
I've fumbled through drops like you wouldn't believe. Like, Hamid, I've sounded so crazy on some drops before.
But, LL, we know you can read. You read movie scripts. You read rhymes. We know you can read, LL. You know, that's not a question. You speak very intellectually. That's not a question. Mayweather? I'm just saying. I'm just saying.
Yeah, Floyd be all right, man. Floyd all right, man. Floyd cool, man.
We got to drop the brand new LL joint. This is on the Go-To album.
Yeah, this is on the Go-To album. And, I would encourage anybody who hasn't seen it, they'll be able to check out the video on the website or the radio station website. Yeah, you'll be able to check that out, you know, in a couple of hours. But for now, this is the brand new joint. It's called The Hustler featuring Movado. It's off that Go-To album, and everything in it is a true story. Facts.
Power 98. Because he's been in the game so long, and we kind of see the emancipation of LL Cool J. How do you go back to, I mean, like when you first started out to now, what is the one major difference in then and now?
I mean, you know, the major difference is that, you know, back then I was trying to prove myself because I was new. Mm-hmm. Now I have to prove myself because I'm not new.
So either way, you're trying to prove yourself.
Yeah.
Now, the Hustler video, I just watched it on World Star Hip Hop.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It takes me to a place like, you know, what's going on in the world right now.
Yeah.
You know, like the whole Ferguson situation.
Yeah, that was, you know, like, and everybody out there, if you want to see the Hustler video, the video for the song that just played, you go to World Star Hip Hop. That's that's the raw version. And then later on, we had the clean version on Power 98. So, you know, as far as Ferguson is concerned, I thought that was, it was horrifying, mm-hmm. You know, and I think that, you know, we gotta figure out, you know, how to make, I think that the only effective idea to me, mm-hmm. or one effective idea, is that we're going to have to do a better job of screening police officers of all ethnicities, mm-hmm. whenever they're going to be in a culture, in an environment that is different from who they are, mm-hmm. like ethnically different, culturally different, etc. So, because I think a lot of this stuff sometimes can be done out of fear, not always out of malice. Mm-hmm. Sometimes. Not all the time. Right. Sometimes it's done out of malice.
Right.
But I'm saying sometimes it could just be, you know, Johnny's, you know, 6'2", and he's ripped up, and he's going to Florida next year, and I'm scared.
Yeah.
So I got to just react crazy because I'm nervous. Mm-hmm. You know, it's that scared, clutch your pocketbook thing that kind of happens, I think, to black men, mm-hmm. Out there in the world. And, you know, I just feel like we just need to screen, you know, our police officers. I don't think it's about trying to, like, degrade the officers. That's not going to work. And I don't think it's about trying to, like, tear down our own neighborhoods. That's not going to work, although it does bring some attention. Mm-hmm. I think ultimately it's just about we just got to educate our people better, and we got to screen people so that we understand. They understand who they're dealing with, and we understand who we're dealing with. You know, it's communication is key, man. I know it's a cliche, but it's true. You got to communicate with people.
Growing up in New York, did you ever go through anything where you had to deal with officers in a situation like that?
Come on, man. I made a song called Illegal Search.
Yeah.
Absolutely. What the hell are you looking for? Can a young man make money anymore? Come on, yeah, absolutely. Mace went and redid it. I mean, yo, I got pulled over every 5 minutes.
Yeah.
I'll tell you a story. I remember in 87, I got my first, this is like when, you know, rap music had just got popping, and I bought my first car. I'd been in the game maybe three, 4 years. Mm-hmm. And And I was riding down the block in my brand new Audi 5000. That's where that slang came from, by the way. Back in the day, it's a long time ago.
I made that up. We know you invented it.
Yeah, long time ago. I just wanted to own that.
Audi 5000.
I want to own that. And I also gave Flavor Flav the Year Boy, but that's a whole other
stuff. I don't know about that.
I'm telling you. Ask Flavor. But I was riding down the street, and you know, some cops rolled past me, and they saw me in the car, and the guy said to me, you know, now mind you, I just sold records, and the crack business must be nice.
Wow.
Yo, I was just like, I just laughed.
Yeah.
You know, but that's, what I'm saying is, I think that, you know, a lot of times the stereotypes are, you know, just, it gets a little, it becomes a bit much, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That's why, like with my new record, it's all about me going home. You know what I'm saying? It, you know, a lot of people focus on the fact that it's in New York, but that's my home. It's not, you know, that's where I'm from. But it's really about me going home and being close to my roots and connected to my people. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? To show that just because you grow and just because you go to another level in Hollywood and you go to another level in your career doesn't mean that you have to forget where you came from.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
And I just think that, you know, we just have to be, you know, unified as a people and then as a country. I think, you know, those the hateful lessons of the past, you know, we got to try to forgive for some things, tolerate some things and move on. But at the same time, you know what I'm saying? We can't have, you know, our boys being shot and killed every day. I'm not, you know, a fan of that at all. You know what I'm saying?
Well, let me ask you this. You got a daughter.
Right.
I've seen you bring your daughter here before.
Mm-hmm. I got three daughters.
Three daughters. The Ray Rice situation. We all watched the video and we like, woo. And you know, everybody's been making comments. If that was my daughter, this was this and this was that. Mm-hmm. What are your feelings on the Ray Rice situation?
Come on, man. I mean, you know, let's be real, man. You can't punch a girl in the jaw, man, and she hit her head on a rail and be like, you got to relax, man.
Yeah.
I mean, it's tough. You know what I'm saying? I mean, look, anybody can have a bad day and have a hard time, but you can't do that. It's just not, and you know, you're right. If it was my daughter, that would be, you know, problematic.
We gotta go see him.
It'd be a problem. You know what I mean? But here's the hard part about it.
Yeah.
Here's the tough part. This is the tough part about life. Everybody talks about, oh, if that was my daughter.
Right.
But the reality is, every time you get involved with somebody's relationship, when it's like that, and you go up there and you do all that, and then they end up running right back.
What do you do?
So I probably wouldn't even get involved.
Yeah.
You know, but I do think that, you know, at the end of the day,
we gotta at least have a conversation.
We gotta set an example. We gotta at least have a conversation with the man.
Yeah,
but the more important thing is that the example has to be set for, you know, these girls out here, the ladies out here, and the fellas, the young boys out here, and the girls need to know that the women need to be safe.
Mm-hmm.
Our women in our country need to feel safe around us, man. You know, can't just go around, you know. I'm 250. I'm just gonna hit you in your chin and knock your little 120 pound self out and just put you out on the elevator. Like, I'm not gonna do that to you.
You know what I mean? Just restrain a little bit.
Well, you know,
or do
some of that Jay-Z kung fu. Do some of that Jay-Z kung fu.
Jay-Z got his own kung fu now.
You got J-Hop on
here.
Get the knees up.
But he was a smart man in the situation, though.
It was perfect.
Yeah.
It was perfect. It was perfect.
Matthew said it was staged.
It might not. Maybe he was scared.
I'm gonna lose that money.
Maybe he was scared, man. You know, we don't know. Somebody had a razor in their hand or something. But I ain't see no zoom ins. I ain't mad at it. I'd have backed up off of two. She looked like a Tasmanian devil. I'd have backed up off of two, man. I had to
Jay-Z
back up off of two,
baby. We teach a new class of Jay-Z Kung Fu.
My man Jay Fu, man.
Anyway, man, I want to say I respect your humbleness. When I was an intern and you first came up here, like, I had heard that, you know, a lot of artists were stuck up and everything. You know, I'm just a little intern. So when you came in, I didn't speak because I didn't know how you were. But then you reached your hand out to me and you spoke to me. That was the first thing that I remember as an intern around the artist, man. So I just want to say I respect your humbleness as an artist.
Thank you, man. I respect you too, homie. And you know, that part of it is, you know, that part, I think, a lot of times when you meet artists like that, that's because they're not really artists. they're really in it for the celebrity mm-hmm. and the money. Mm-hmm. And, you know, there's a difference between the celebrity and the artist, although they can be one and the same.
Right.
You know, when you're an artist, you appreciate your music being on the radio, people hearing you, seeing your right. videos, stuff like that. The celebrity thing's a little different.
Yeah.
You know, I'm famous and, you know.
You got to respect me.
Yo.
You got to respect me in my circle.
You know, you see how I'm moving. You see how I'm moving. You know?
Man, LL is live in the studio. We take some of our phone calls, 570-WPG. Tell Freddie Cackett, like 1-800-525-0098. We got
up in the hard place, test his face like Bronson, burn in your mouth, get kicked in your Johnson, meet Jason, dagger with Hagler strength, Popeye nuts, big 4-5 on me with bust, yeah, jump out of character, get ran on him, Usain Bolt, with lightning bolts, fly out the cannon dawn, meet me at the spot, all messiahs, 60 real, no liars, I hate thieves, I make thieves also, blow up your torso, chop fingers, chew you like dog bones, biscuit ass. Pussy in my book, talk. Pussy in my book, yo.
Took it out the OT, mean I came here to cut you out. Front a couple pieces, told him figure the puzzle out. It was all a dream, then I put the duffel out. Gave him a ball of green, that's what I call a Brussels sprout. What the fuck you bout? Nothing. I'm the toughest motherfucker coming up this route. I'm bugging, put your knuckles out. And I can show you better than I can tell you. Nowadays I'm landing on fans like Miguel do. Put it all on the bread, that's bruschetta, nigga. Open up your chest like I'm looking for some treasure, nigga. I'ma let you ride, but keep your shit together, nigga. Now don't touch the radio or dirty up my leather, nigga. Got respect for Ellen Chef, both of them dare to me. But all y'all other rap niggas scared of me. They said don't fuck with battle rap, cause they wouldn't blow. Now I just got more than what you got paid for a show, nigga. Whoa.
Yeah, I'm nice, nigga. Yeah, I'm nice, nigga.
Ray Kwan, the chef. Murder
yeah,
move.
I'm nice,
yeah.
Nigga.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I'm nice.
Come on,
nigga.
Man, bring me in the building, hip hop.
Yeah,
what up?
I'm nice, yeah. You don't think so. I think your bitch thinks I will.
I'm a bad motherfucker. Rush niggas, Chris Tucker. Ball harder than the Ruckers, make your bitch lips fucker. Baby boy, you get scarred. These bars is box cutters. Tigers with the putter, slick talking stutter. When I'm busting out the Magnum, I ain't talking about rubbers. When I'm tucking these lames in, I ain't talking about covers. I divorced the game and remarried your motherfucker. Shit, I'm coming on myself. Who wanna be my baby mother? Pause, Giant, Andre, y'all bitches, Beyonce. LL Cool, ain't nobody Beyonce. Red dots on heads is Queens, not Bombay. Get an angle on you, leave your forehead concave. 3 decades getting the brick shade, getting it whipped page. You're about to your switchblade. Rambo to your juggler, fucking baloney smugglers. Nobody's fucking with me. Tell them all, come and get me.
Yeah, I'm nice, nigga.
Nicky, Nicky, Nicky Jam.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Yeah.
A long, long night. Say you, baby, to see. Dime que
pasó esta vez? ¿Por qué me llamas? ¿Será que peleas otra vez con tu novio y te dejó con ganas? ¿Ya te diste cuenta que esta relación no es sana? ¿Y si tu cama está fría, puedes quedarte en la mía?